Good morning, students. Today we are going to see the rationalization of irrational numbers. So in that we have to see rationalization of denominator. Okay. So first we will see what is meant by rationalization of irrational number. So everyone know that irrational number. So the number which we can not express into the form of p by q. Correct. It means that the number decimal expansion of such a number is which type of non-terminating, non-recurring, non-terminating, non-repetitive, correct? So here we have to do the rationalization of such an irrational number. Rationalization of an irrational number means we have to convert irrational number into the rational number form. Okay? So this is called the rationalization of irrational number. The irrational number convert into the rational number. Okay? So first we will see this supposed to be which number. This root 2 is an irrational number, root 3 is an irrational number, root 7 is an irrational number. So many are the numbers are irrational numbers. So this irrational number in which form? Monomial irrational means only one term is there. Correct? There are the many terms are there. Okay, so there also we have to do the rationalization of such a irrational number. Okay. So for that purpose, first we will see what is the rule for the rationalization of irrational number. Okay. So suppose this is under root a and here n. Okay. Now we have to rationalize this number, right? So when you will rationalize this number, the rule is here. Actually, this number we can write in which form? A raised to 1 by n. Correct? This number we can write into the form A raised to 1 by n. So when you have to rationalize this, then how you will write this number? A raised to 1 minus 1 by n. In this way we have to rationalize this given irrational number. Okay, so here we will see this root 2, how to rationalize the root 2. Correct? Now root 2, how we can express? We have already learned in the last year, suppose root 4. So what is the root 4? Means square root of 4 is, of course, square root of 4 is 2. Correct? Square root of it means this sign is of square root sign. Means if it is not any number, in the law we have taken this number as a n and this 4 as a a. Correct? And is any number, right? But here it is not that any number means what we are pronouncing here root 4, square root of 4. Square root means square, correct? Na? So here 2 is there. Here what is present? 2 is there. So how you will write this number 4 raised to 1 by 2. 4 raised to 1 by 2. So this number we can express in this form. If it is 3 there, then how we can express? 4 raised to 1 by 3. Or here any number and here 3 there, then that number raised to 1 by 3. Okay. So this is called, this form is also called what? Square root of 4. This number is also called square root of 4. Then here this 4 we can represent again which form? 2 raised to 2. 2 raised to 2 raised to 1 by 2. Okay. Now everyone, we have learned already the rule is what? A raised to n raised to n. Which law exponent? A raised to n raised to n. So you will get a raised to n multiplied by n. Means exponent of the exponent, power of power, right? So a raised to n raised to n. So you will get a raised to n into n. Okay. So here 2 raised to 2 into 1 by 2. So this root 2 will get cancelled. So you will get 2. Understood? So how you got square root? Square root means here sign is there of square root. Okay, if it is not there any particular number, then it is square root. So how we can express that square root? raise to that any number raise to 1 by 2. Understood? So similarly, we have to use such concept on here also. Here root 2. We have to rationalize. Correct? We have to rationalize this root 2. Right? So this number in this form, how we will write a raised to 1 by n? Means here root sign in that, what is a? And here in this sign, what is the n? So similarly here, what is the not there any number means 2 always present, right? So you will write 2 raised to 1 by 2. Okay, 2 raised to 1 by 2. Now this is the 2 is square of any number? No, we have to now rationalize this number, okay? Rationalize this irrational number. So where we have to rationalize this any irrational number? What is the step after expressing such a number into this form? Then what we have to do? A raised to 1 minus 1 by n. Okay? So here 2 raised to 1 minus 1 by n. 1 by n means what is? 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Correct? So you will get 2 raised to, here 2 ones are 2 minus this 1 upon 2. Understood everyone? So here you will get 2 raised to 2 minus 1, 1. 1 by 2. And 1 by 2 means what? What is 1 by 2? 1 by 2 means what you are? This number. 1 by 2. 2 raised to 1 by 2 means? 2 raised to 1 by 2 means your root 2. Correct? So this is the rationalizing factor. What is the rationalizing factor? 2 raised to 1 by 2. Understood everyone? What we have done here? We have expressed first which number we have to rationalize? This root 2. Correct? The root 2 we have to rationalize because root 2 is irrational number. Then we have to express this number in this form. Okay? So 2 raised to 1 by 2. Right? So 2 raised to 1 by 2. Now we have to rationalize this. So what is the rationalizing factor? This. A raised to 1 minus 1 by n. So here 2 raised to 1 minus 1 by n is what you have? 1 by 2. Correct? So here we have to simplify this exponent. Right? So 2, this raised to 2 ones are 2 minus 1 by 2. This should be in the form of like exponent form, right? So if you write in this way, 2 raised to 1 minus 2, this is wrong. Right? So it should like this only. So 2 minus 1 by 2. So you will get 2 raised to 1 by 2. Right? We got here at the final step 2 raised to 1 by 2. Then 2 raised to 1 by 2 means what here? Root 2. Because root 2 we are expressing in this form now. So this form is this only and this form is this only. Okay, so finally we got here 2 raised to 1 by 2. 2 raised to 1 by 2 means what? This 2 raised to 1 by 2 means what? Root 2. Okay, so what is the rationalizing factor? What is the rationalizing factor for this root 2? It is this. This means root 2 only. Understood everyone? We are finding the rationalizing factor for this. Rationalizing factor for root 2 is what you got? 2 raised to 1 by 2. And 2 raised to 1 by 2 means what? Root 2 only. So rationalizing factor is what? Rationalizing factor is root 2. Correct? So how you will rationalize this number? See, root 2, we have to make the product of this root 2 into root 2. Okay? So root 2 into root 2, what? 2 you will get. So this irrational number we can convert into the rational number, okay? So rationalizing factor means we have to multiply for that sake, okay? So root 2 multiply by root 2, right? Because we got a rationalizing factor 2 raised to 1 by 2. 2 raised to 1 by 2 means root 2, okay? So this irrational number we have converted into the rational number. Understood everyone? Now we will see rationalization of denominator. Now, like this, we will solve. Suppose the next example is rationalize the denominator 2 by root 3. Okay, means if you have to rationalize the denominator, what is the denominator? Root 3. Okay, now we have to, this is the irrational number, now we have to rationalize this. Means this irrational number we have to convert into the rational number. Okay, so every irrational number having the rationalizing factor is number itself. Means this number only the rationalizing factor for this, right? So we have seen in the first example how it is possible, correct? So how we got that same number in the rationalizing factor. Okay, so here we have to rationalize this denominator, means this irrational number we have to convert into the rational number. So how you will do this? First you will write this number 2 by root 3. Now we have to multiply with this root 3. 2 by root 3, then root 3 we have to rationalize, so we have to multiply with also root 3. Correct? But when we have learned already, when you will do the addition, subtraction, multiplication for the numerators, then we have to, at the same time you have to do, sorry, we have already learned when you will multiply to this denominator or numerator, then we have to multiply to numerator. Okay, then here 2 by root 3, so here 2 by root 3 we have to rationalize this denominator. So what is the rationalizing factor for this? That number itself, means rationalize the denominator, then what is the rationalizing factor? That same, it is root 3 into root 3, correct? So here also we have to multiply with numerator, we have to multiply with the numerator with root 3, because we have multiplied to denominator, so at the same time we have to multiply for the numerator. Okay, so here you will get 2 into root 3, that simply 2 root 3. This is for numerator and this is your denominator. So root 3 into root 3, you will get 3. Understood? So this is the rationalization of denominator of 2 by root 3. And what is the rationalizing factor? Rationalizing factor is what? By which number we have rationalized this number? By root 3. So rationalizing factor is root 3. Understood everyone? Now we will see the next example. Okay, next example is rationalize the denominator 2 by 3 root 3. Okay, so what is the denominator? Denominator is 3 root 3. Okay, so in that we have to rationalize the denominator. Means in the denominator there is an irrational number. Okay, so which one irrational number? Root 3 is a irrational number. Now root 3 we have to convert into rational number because it is the irrational. Okay, so how you will do this? 2 upon 3 root 3, by which number we have to multiply? To the denominator, by root 3. Okay, and when you will multiply by with root 3, then at the same time here also we have to multiply with root 3. Correct? So in this way we will rationalize the denominator, right? So here these two multiply by, we cannot cancel out this because we are rationalizing denominator, right? So here these two multiply by root 3, so you will get 2 multiply by root 3, right? 2 root 3, right? And this 3 multiply by, now root 3 into root 3, that 3 only, correct? So here this 2 root 3 upon 3 3s are 9. Understood? So in this way we have this irrational number we have converted into the rational number. Understood everyone? So what is the rationalizing factor? Rationalizing factor is root 3. Understood? Rationalizing factor is root 3. Now next example, 1 upon 3 plus root 3. So before in that example we have learned there is a multiplication, correct? So simply we have to multiply with that irrational number to the numerator and denominator. Now here 1 upon this irrational denominator comes in the form of which? Binomial form. Okay, this is binomial form. So and it comes, these two terms comes together with plus sign, sometimes it comes with the minus sign. So well, at such a examples, what we have to do here, when you will rationalize the denominator, we have to multiply to the numerator and denominator with the denominator only, whatever, with the irrational number, correct? But here 3 plus root 2, right? So when you have to multiply with, in this example, in this such cases, if plus sign is there, then we have to multiply with both this, to take this number with negative sign, means with opposing operation. Not only we have to multiply with, or we have to multiply with the root 2. Okay? Because this number comes with the addition form, that 3 plus root 2. Okay? So when you will rationalize such types of denominator, we have to take the opposite operation what is given here, right? So here 3 plus, then the rationalizing factor will come 3 minus root 2. So when if you are being multiplying to the numerator denominator by this number, at the same time you have to multiply with this numerator with the same number. Understood? Only we have to keep in mind, if the denominator is in this form, just we have to multiply with the same number but with opposite operation. Okay, so if it is the plus, then we have to multiply it by taking minus sign. Understood? Now next, here multiplications of numerator upon multiplication of denominator. So here 1 multiplied by 3 minus root 2. So that you will get, means if any number is multiplied with 1, then you will get the same number, correct? So 3 minus root 2. And here we will write this denominator like this form, because 3 plus root 2 is one of the number. Which sign is there? Multiplication, right? And here 3 minus root 2. Understood? Now see the denominator very properly. We have learned already such a type of identities in the last year. See, these numbers comes with, in one bracket there is a plus and another bracket there is a minus. Means two terms are together with plus and minus sign. In which form? Product form. Okay. So do you remember this identity? Identity is A plus B and into second bracket A minus B. What is the identity for such a number or for such a factor? A plus B, A minus B. This is the standard identity. Which one? It is A square minus B square. Correct? So here A square minus B square. This identity is there. Right? So, or if the numbers comes into this form A square minus B square, then how we can factorize this? A plus B and A minus B, means A plus B into A minus B. Now, here we have the same number in this way, right? A plus B means 3 plus root 2 and A minus B means 3 minus root 2. Means sometimes A minus B will come first, A plus B will come afterwards. It is same only. Product of any two numbers, if we exchange the numbers, means 3 multiplied by 4, it is 12. That is the same 4 multiplied by 3. Okay. So 3 multiplied by 4 equals to 4 multiplied by 3. It is same. So same here. Sometimes this sign will be here. So this sign will be there, right? So the property is same. Identity is same. A square minus B square. Understood? Now here, this 3 minus root 2, according to that, what will be there? According to the identity A plus B, A minus B. A means your this A and this is B. Okay, this is A, this is B. So A plus B, A minus B. So what is the A square? A square means whose square? 3 square. Correct? 3 square minus B square means whose square? Root 2 square. Okay. So here 3 minus root 2 as it is. 3 minus root 2 upon. What is 3 square? 3 square is 9. Then minus root 2 square. Root 2 square means what? Any number square, how we can express? Suppose 7 square. 7 square means what? 7 into 7. So similarly, root 2 square means root 2 multiplied by root 2. So we have learned already in the previous example, root 2 into root 2 rationalizing factor, then what will be the 2? So say root 2 square is what? Any root number square is that number itself. Okay. So here square root number having the square is number itself. So here 2 will be there. So you will get, here we cannot subtract this number. The number becomes as it is 3 minus root 2 upon 9 minus 2. 9 minus 2 is how much? 7. So you will get this answer. Okay. So what was your denominator? 3 plus root 2. Okay. One number and another number is irrational number. Right. So we have rationalized the denominator in this form and you got the denominator in 7. 7, 7 is rational number. Correct. So 3 minus root 2 by 7. Understood everyone? So what is the rationalizing factor here? Rationalizing factor is 3 minus root 2. Understood? So what is the rationalizing factor? 3 minus root 2. Now we will see the next example. Here what we will do? What is the next step will come? Yes, 5 upon root 3 minus root 5. What is the rationalizing factor? Yes, root 3 plus root 5. Okay. So we have to take the opposite side. So here 5 upon root 3 minus root 5. This numerator denominator we have to keep as it is. And when you will go for the rationalizing denominator, what is the rationalizing denominator? If minus sign is there, then you will get, maybe we have to write plus sign. Root 3 plus root 5. If you are multiplying the denominator with one of the number, then you have to, at the same time, you have to multiply to numerators. Understood everyone this step? Then what is the next step? Multiplications of numerator and multiplication of denominator. Okay. So here, what is the multiplication become? 5 in bracket root 3 plus root 5. Correct? Then divided by, here this root 3 minus root 5 and in second bracket root 3 plus root 5. If there is no any sign between these two brackets, it means that which one sign is the multiplication sign. Correct? Means if you will give the multiplication sign or if you will not, then there is no any problem. Okay, so just it is multiplication sign is there always. Okay, so now here this number will remain as it is, 5 in bracket root 3 plus root 5 upon, here a is what? Your root 3. And what is b? B is your root 5. Okay, so root 3 means a minus b and a plus b. So what is the identity? A minus b, a plus b, a square minus b square. So what is a? A is your root 3. Okay. So what is the root 3 square? Root 3 square is 3. Minus what is b square? B is what? Root 5. Correct? Root 5. So what is the root 5 square? Root 5 square is 5. So you will get here 5 in bracket root 3 plus root 5 upon 3 minus 5 minus 2. Understood? 3 minus 5 minus 2. This number we can express in this form. This minus sign means we In this way, we have rationalized the denominator. Okay. So, what is the rationalizing factor for this? Rationalizing factor is root 3 plus root 5. Understood, everyone? Now, we will see the next example.
Next example, 7 plus 3 root 5 upon 7 minus 3 root 5. Okay. So, we have to rationalize this number. Then, now what will be the rationalizing factor for this? Means if we have to rationalize this number, then what is the rationalizing factor? Rationalizing factor is, what is here? 7 minus 3 root 5. So, what is the opposite number will be there? 7 plus 3 root 5. Means opposite sign we have to use. Okay. So, here 7 plus 3 root 5 upon 7 minus 3 root 5. This number as it is we have to write and multiply with. What is rationalizing factor? By which number we have to multiply here for the denominator and the numerator? Yes, 7 plus 3 root 5. Okay. So, 7 plus 3 root 5 and here 7 plus 3 root 5. Understood everyone? Now, next step is what? Multiplication of numerator upon multiplication of denominator. Correct? So, here 7 plus 3 root 5 into 7 plus 3 root 5 upon what is A minus B, A plus B. So, what will be there? A minus B, A plus B identity, then A square minus B square. Correct? So, what is here? A is your 7. And what is B? B is what? 3 root 5. Correct? So, A square minus B square. Why? Because A minus B, A plus B, that form we have. Correct? Means when you will make the multiplication of denominator, so you will get 7 minus 3 root 5 into 7 plus 3 root 5. Correct? Now this number, 7 plus 3 root 5 and 7 plus 3 root 5. See, here in both the brackets, same numbers are there. Correct? So, in both the brackets, same numbers are there. Means, we have learned this. Suppose, 2 multiplied by 2. Or, then, suppose 4 in second bracket, 4. It means that 4 multiplied by 4. So, 2 multiplied by 2 means how you can express this? 2 to the 4 that we know. Right? But how you will express into the another form, that is 2 square. Correct? And then 2 square is this 4. Right? So, similarly how we can express this number 4 bracket 4 into 4, then you will get 4 square. That is 4 square is 16. Means 4 fours are 16. Correct? So, this identity form is there. Right? So, which identity will be there? First, see, we will write this number in which form? 7 plus 3 root 5 bracket square. Can we write like this? Yes, of course, because both the signs are same. Both the signs are same. Both the terms in both the brackets, it is same. Terms in both brackets are same with the same sign. So, we can express these two brackets, we can express in this manner. Okay. 7 plus 3 root 5 square upon here. Now, which identity came here? A minus B. This is your B. Correct? And this is your A. So, A minus B. Second bracket. A plus B. So, what will be there? A square minus B square. So, what is A square? A square means you will get 7 square. Right? 7 square minus B square means what? 3 root 5 bracket square. 3 root 5 bracket square. Right? So, here, here a plus b bracket square identity. Everyone knows that a plus b bracket square identity. A plus b bracket square identity. What say? A plus b bracket square. A square plus 2ab plus b square. Now this identity we will use here. Correct. So now what is your a? A is your 7, and what is your b? B is 3 root 5. B is your 3 root 5. Okay. So here a square means what square? 7 square. Correct. So 7 square plus 2 into a. A is what? 7 into b. B is what? 3 root 5. Your b is what? 3 root 5. Understood? Plus b square. B square means what square? 3 root 5 bracket square. 3 root 5 bracket square. Correct? Upon here 7 square. 7 square is what? 49. 7 square is 49 minus 3 square. See here in this bracket square, there have been two numbers in which form came that product form. 3 root 5 means 3 multiplied by root 5. Okay. 3 root 5 means 3 multiplied by root 5. So what is the 3 square? 3 square is 9. 3 square is 9 multiplied by root 5 square. Root 5 square is 5. Okay. So 9 5s are 45. So you will get this number. Now what is the 7 square? 7 square is 49. We are simplifying this numerator. Okay. 7 square is 49. Then we have to make the multiplication of these three numbers. 7, 2 7s are 14. 14 3s are 42. Correct? 2 7s are 14. 14 3s are 42. 42 root 5 plus 42 root 5 plus here what is the 3 square? 3 square is 9 multiplied by root 5 square is 5. Understood everyone this numerator how to simplify? By using identity, right? If it is there, then 49 minus 9 5s are 45. Okay, so here this 49 and this 9 5s are 45 will come. Correct? 49 plus 45. If you will add this number, we will write this step. So 49 plus 45 plus 42 root 5 upon here 49 minus 45 we will get 4. Okay. So here this number we have to add. 5 plus 9 14. Then 4 plus 4 8 plus 1 9 plus 42 root 5 by 4. Okay. Then here, what is the common factor in these two numbers? Is it 4 or is it 2? Means we have to find out the common factor from this both the numbers 94 and 42. Okay. So we will erase this example. We will solve afterwards. So here, this 94 and 42 in that, what is common number? If you take the 2, then 2 4s are 8, 1 remaining 2 7s are 14. Correct? Is it possible? 4, 4 2s are 8, 1 remaining 9, then 14. So 4, 14 is not comes in the table of 4. So we can tell that 2 is common outside from this 2 number. Correct? So if you take this 2 common, so in bracket what will be there? 2 4 are 8. What is remaining? 1. Then 2 7 are 14. Plus here 2 2 are 4 and 2 1 are 2. Correct. Just only what we have done. We have taken one common number outside from both. Okay. So root 5 as it is upon 4. So here we can simplify. 2 1 are 2, 2 2 are 4. Simply we will get this number 47 plus 21 root 5 upon 2. Understood everyone this example? Now we will see another one example. Okay, next example. 2 root 3 minus root 5 upon 2 root 2 plus 3 root 3. So what will be the rationalizing factor for this? 2 root 2 plus instead of what will come? Minus, correct. So 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3, correct. So by this number, with but taking the negative sign, we will multiply to both the numerator and denominator, right. So here 2 root 3 minus root 5 upon 2 root 2 plus 3 root 3. Keep in mind that first we have to write as it is number whatever given, and then multiply with denominator by taking the opposite sign. Okay. So here 2 root 2, which sign will come? Minus 3 root 3 upon 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. Okay. Now we have to make, next step is what? We have to make multiplications of numerator upon multiplication of denominator. Okay. So here 2 root 3 minus root 5 in bracket, second bracket, 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3 upon your multiplication of denominator. So 2 root 2 plus 3 root 3, second bracket, 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. Understood everyone how to write multiplication of denominator? So it is very easy, only lengthy but very easy. We have to make the multiplication of denominator by keeping whole numbers of the denominator, means both the numbers, into the separate bracket. Okay. So 2 root 2 plus 3 root 3 first bracket, and in the second bracket what is there? 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. Understood everyone? So now we will see the next step. Here 2 root 3 minus root 5, and here 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. If you will observe very properly this numerator, then sign is same, okay, but it not follows the what? Identity, standard identity, such as a minus b bracket square, because here a is what? 2 root 3, and here a is what? 2 root 2. Then minus sign is there, and second term is the root 5, and here 3 root 6. So this is totally different. So we have to do the one-to-one multiplication, right? Means we have to multiply with one number to both this number, afterward this number. Okay. So we have learned how to multiply this. So here we will write, first we will take from this bracket, we will take this first term, what? 2 root 3, and then we will multiply to hold this bracket. Okay. So here 2 root 3 multiply means in bracket 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. Understood everyone? Now we have, what we have done, by this number from the first bracket we have multiplied to whole second bracket, correct? Now next, what is we have to give the this sign? If negative sign, then negative sign. But here, if it is a negative sign, then we have to keep the bracket. Okay, because this here the different signs are there, so sign will get changed because of this negative sign. Right? Now, by which number we have to multiply? We have to multiply with root 5 to hold this bracket numbers. Okay? So root 5 in bracket, what is 2 root 2 minus 3 root 3. Understood everyone? This multiplication you have to carry out and divided by here. Here we will use the identity a plus b, a minus b. Yes, of course. This is your a, this is your a plus minus, and what is b? 3 root 3, and here 3 root 3, correct? So a plus b, a minus b, which one identity? A square minus b square. So a square means whole square? 2 root 2 square. Okay, so 2 root 2 square, a square minus b square. B square means whole square? 3 root 3 bracket square. Correct? Understood everyone this step? Now we have to know, we know that this how to multiply this 1 to 1 multiplication, and here, correct? Then see here, very clearly this 2 root 3 multiply by 2 root 2, correct? 2 root 3 multiply by 2 root 2, right? Then we sign minus. Again we have to multiply to this by this number 2 inside number. 2 root 3 multiply by 3 root 3. Right? Then minus in bracket. So we have to multiply to this number and again to this number. Okay? So root 5 multiply by 2 root 2. Understood everyone? Root 5 multiply by 2 root 2. Then which sign is there? Minus. Then again we have to multiply this by this number 2 inside number. Then root 5 multiply by 3 root 3. Got everyone? Multiplication, this number outside number we have to multiply to each term from the bracket. So 2 root 3 multiply by 2 root 2. Then we sign minus, again 2 root 3 multiply by 3 root 3. Okay. Then minus and keep the bracket. Then root 5 multiply by 2 root 2 minus root 5 multiply by 3 root 3. Okay. Then divided by. Here, what is the 2 square? Now we will do the direct calculation. What is the 2 square? 4. Keep in mind, 2 square is 4. And this, what is the relation between these two numbers? Multiplication. Correct? And root 2 square is what? 2 always. Root 2 square is 2. And here we got 2 square is 4. So you will get 4 for this square. 4 multiplied by this square is what? 2. So 4 2s are 8. Right? Then we say minus. Here 3 square is 9 and root 3 square is 3. So 9 3s are 27. Okay? 9 3s are 27. Understood? Now here we have already learned in the previous lecture how to multiply. Right? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division of rational number, irrational numbers, rational number, right? So we have learned. So here, this 2 add into 2. 2 multiply by 2, 4. Correct? And here root 3 into root 2. So root 3 and root 2. Any if 2 numbers are there into the bracket sign, means square root sign. So we can take this together. Root 3 2 are 6. Understood? So same property we will use here. These two 2s are 4. Root 3 into root 2 root 6, right? Then minus 3 twos are 6. Here 3 twos are 6. Okay. And what is the root 3 multiplied by root 3? Here this root 3 multiplied by root 3. What is the root 3 multiplied by root 3? 3 only. Right? So this root 3 into root 3, 3. And this 2 into 3, 2 3s are 6. So 6 3s are 18. Understood everyone? Or I will write here mistake. 2 multiplied by this 3 multiplied by root 3 into root 3, that is 3. Now minus. See here. Now at the same time I am multiplying and removing the bracket. Root 5 into root 2. Like this step we will use here. So root 10. Okay, and here 2 multiplies there. So here not there means here 1. So 1 multiplied by 2, that is 2. And root 5 into root 2, root 10. Understood? Now this minus minus will come plus. Correct? Now here root 5 into root 3, root 15. And here not there in number means 1 always present. So 1 multiplied by 3, that is 3 into 5 into 3, that is 5 threes are 15. Understood everyone? Now divided by 8 minus 27. 8 minus 27, how many? 19, correct? You will get here, bigger number is negative, so minus 19. Okay, now we will carry out the next step. 4 root 6 minus 3 3s are 9, 9 2s are 18. Okay, minus 2 root 10 plus 3 root 15 upon minus 19. Okay, next step is here. We will take this minus 18 first. Then this plus 4 root 6 minus 2 root 10 plus 3 root 15 upon here minus 19. Okay. Now this minus 19, this minus sign we will shift to here. Okay. So here we will keep the bracket for this, and this minus sign we will shift to upward. So that is minus, and this 19 will remain as it is. So last step will this inside sign will come change. So this minus minus will become plus. So 18, this plus minus, minus 4 root 6, this minus minus, this plus 2 root 10, and plus minus minus 3 root 15 upon 19. Understood everyone? So next example we will see on the next lecture. Okay.